For Best Director, the nominees are Catherine Bigelow for The Hurt Locker, James Cameron, Avatar, Lee Daniels for Precious, Jason Reitman for Up in the Air, and Quentin Tarantino for Inglourious Basterds. The nominees for Best Picture are Avatar, The Blind Side, District 9, An Education, The Hurt Locker, Inglourious Basterds, Precious, A Serious Man, Up, and Up in the Air.
And I think the winner of the Best Director Oscar this year will be Catherine Bigelow for The Hurt Locker, and I think the Best Film will be also The Hurt Locker. Francis?
I think the Best Director is going to be James Cameron, and I think the Best Picture is going to be Avatar.
Okay, we have a discussion. Robin Milling.
I think the Best Director will be Quentin Tarantino, and the Best Film will be The Hurt Locker.
Wow, this is really much more to discuss than I thought we'd have. This is a real, well, we both agreed on The Hurt Locker. I think nothing's going to stop, but you don't think Catherine, either of you think Catherine Bigelow's a bandwagon for being the first woman to ever win will be stopped.
Well, I think that's the bandwagon going on for her. It's like, oh, she's going to be the first woman to win the Academy Award. They're not saying it because of her great direction of The Hurt Locker. It's because she'll be the first woman, and I think that's a bit annoying for me because I just don't want to give it to her because just to make history, I want to give it to the person who made the best film. I think it's James Cameron because his film really
for Avatar,
had
yeah.
the best heightened emotional response and yes, the character.
Money ever, anything ever.
The Hurt Locker didn't have heightened emotional response.
The Hurt Locker, the characters were very restrained. Like, it was clear, I don't have anything against the movie, but it was clear in Avatar there was more of an emotional tour de force here. The characters were simplistic, yes. The story, pretty much you could say, was maybe not the most complex story, but I thought it really showed this passion and the pain of this one guy.
How old are you? Again, that's why you loved Avatar.
And the thing is,
say no more.
A lot of people have gone to see it more than once.
I just thought there was like such emotional passion in Avatar that I did not see in The Hurt Locker. The Hurt Locker, yes, a good film, a skilled film, but in my opinion, not the movie that I want to cap the decade with. I'd rather cap it with Avatar.
Okay, Robin.
Fair enough.
I agree with you about The Hurt Locker, but not Quentin Tarantino.
Okay, the fact that The Hurt Locker was directed by a woman, mm-hmm. made it. Because her point of view was so unlike anything we've ever seen in a war picture.
Yes, yes.
And coming from a woman, that is so refreshing. So to say that she shouldn't win because she's a woman, to me, feels a little sexist.
I'm not saying she should. I'm just saying, like, I don't want to give it to her just because of that reason. I want to give it to her if she had the best quality film.
Right.
Yeah.
But the fact that she was nominated for a war film being a woman, people are saying, well, she's a woman, what does she know about war, is very unfair. And I think she did a great job.
Brilliant.
That movie was done in like 2 weeks mm-hmm. in Jordan, which is in a state of unrest, in the summer. Mm-hmm. Jeremy Renner wore like this 50-pound bomb suit.
Which he kept fainting in.
Exactly.
He nearly died doing that movie.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a brilliant film.
But why Quentin Tarantino?
Okay, Tarantino I go with because he got tremendous performances out of all the actors.
Okay.
Agreed.
And
except Brad Pitt.
Well,
he was all right. He was better than he's been. Yeah.
And it kept me on the edge of my seat. Okay. I mean, you know, I was actually toying for that as Best Picture in Glorious Bastards. It's a mm-hmm. great film.
Of course.
But it's interesting because how many times do directors get nominated and not get nominated for Best Picture and vice versa?
True.
How does that happen?
Well, they want to spread the wealth, as it were.
Yeah. I think it's just weird politics and campaigns and so it gets nominated.
Weird
for
campaigns,
the picture,
that's like, Hollywood. Yeah. It's all about the campaign, you know.
Right.
And The Hurt Locker is It's a very small comic, or, well, they're not that small. Summit, which has the Twilight movies, yeah. please. And they released it like it wasn't going to be a hit. And
sleeper film.
Yeah. And the other films, I don't think, are really in contention at all, any of the rest
they
of them.
They just don't have, like, the big heat and buzz going for them.
I think it's between... And this year, also, we have to say there's a preferential ballot, which is too difficult and complex to explain to on television in the time we have left. But Avatar, I mean, the most money ever... Hurt Locker would be the lowest, you know, grossing film ever to win, if it wins. The Hurt Locker, by the way, has won the Editing Guild. It won the Producers Guild.
Yeah, and it was nominated for 9 Oscars.
It just swept the BAFTAs last night. It won 6 out of 8 awards, including Best Picture in England, where it was up against other very big British films like An Education.
And the tension is going to be brewing because you've got James Cameron versus Catherine Bigelow, who were married.
Exactly.
I think overhyped, but yeah.
Well, I mean, but he's being very gracious to her and saying, I want Catherine to win. And
right,
Tarantino said, I want Catherine to win. Well, maybe she will win if you keep telling him to vote for her. She's a lovely...
Catherine Bigelow!
You've interviewed her. She's a lovely... Love her. She's so tall.
And beautiful. And talented.
And wears high heels like the... I mean, like 7-inch stiletto heels, and she's like 7 feet tall. Anyway, so it's like... I think she's the inspiration for the Na'vi characters being so big! I said, oh, it's just his... Catherine Bigelow fantasy.
Well, I think he ran the idea for Avatar by Catherine.
Oh, I'm sure he did.
They discuss a lot.
I think they're soulmates still. I really think they are, because she's brilliant.
Yes.
I mean, this film is just, it's like, did you ever see Wages of Fear, the Henri-Georges Clouzot film, which was about these men in the, 4 men in a truck going over the Andes with TNT? So, dynamite.
On the edge of your seat.
For the home, which is what the bomb squad... Hurt Locker, oh my God, are they going to get blown? The minute the film starts, you're like, oh my God, they're going to get blown out. And you're like that for the rest of the film. I think that's...
And that's worthy of an Oscar in my book.
Well, I want to thank Frances Chervenak. Eloquent as always. And Robin Milling, thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
It was wonderful today. And it's, you know, the Oscar party of the year as far as I'm concerned here on the Stephen Holt Show. Have a fabulous...
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Thank you.